Sunday outside! And it might actually be a Sunday outside video this week. Let's read your comments, let's see what you've been saying all week.
Just trying to find somewhere to start Sunday outside, and I just randomly found this key on the tree. I wonder how long that's been there. Oh, it's so rusty. There's bits of it coming off in my hand. I'm gonna play. Is that a screw? No, it's a bit of tree. I wonder how long that's been hung up on there. See, I like thinking of stories. You can just imagine, can't you? Like, have you ever seen the Saw films? This is the key that someone's meant to have found and they never ever did, and someone's died. I wonder what the key's for. I wonder where the lock is. I don't believe that. I can't find anywhere to sit. That's the problem with Hammersmith. And the one place I want to sit down, someone's already filming. I just want somewhere to sit down.
I'm going to have to read your comments here. You see, Hammersmith is not really a destination to go to if you're wanting to have somewhere peaceful to relax. It's mainly a living and office working place. It's got a few shops, it's got King Street. But Hammersmith is not a destination to go to relax. There is no green space that is also quiet. Because you've got the Hammersmith Bridge, flyover in the background, and there's Hammersmith Bridge, which is all clattery. They use the towpath on the Richmond side, but it's just full of people running. And it's, I find running in Hammersmith and on the Richmond side of it as well, pretty pointless. Because all you're doing is breathing in all these fumes. You're not being healthy, you're just ingesting congestion fumes. Anyway, that's that bit over with. So Sunday outside last week, I had Michael Jameson reply and leave comments because I went to Chesham last week. And he says, I used to live here. And Luke Carrigan put, Muse Day outside nearly. I find that rather amusing. It's a good word, isn't it, Muse Day? Sounds like muesli. Michael Jameson put, used to work in that Waitrose. I went into that Waitrose as well. Michael Jameson come to them put, our electricity bill tripled with the smart meter, so we swapped it as soon as possible. Financially crippling decision. Awful, awful, awful. Yeah, I need to make a video about how bad they are. Smart meters, the rubbish. Big Joe Angels put, the Chesh. Or Rome, as I used to call it. And ex-Cheshire too, says Michael Jameson again. Don Doherty or Doherty. It's Finchley Road to Wembley Park on the Metropolitan Line. No, it's Finchley Road to Wembley Park on the Metropolitan Line. It takes 8 minutes. Chesham to Chalfont takes 7 minutes. So I was a minute out. Something to do with distance. I can't remember if it's distance or time, which is the longest. But anyway, S125-ish. Was down in London yesterday, went to Japan Centre in Westfield, Shepherd's Bush, and went to West Ruislip yesterday, which was at the end of the Central Line. Yeah, I probably will be going to West Ruislip. There's not a lot in West Ruislip though. Yeah, so this week is a bit of a cop-out because I'm always, well not always, but nearly always in Hammersmith because I live very close to Hammersmith. So it is an end of the land station video, really, you know, because the Hammersmith and City and the Circle Line stop here. But I know it's not as exciting because I'm here all the time. The Metropolitan Line went all the way to Aylesbury, home of Food Review UK. I was reading there. It's more like a conventional railway. It really is the Metropolitan Railway Line. It really is, especially with the transverse seating. So you can sit forward when you're going somewhere. Or backwards, if you like. What's the craziest encounter you've ever had with a customer at work, says Scallop Quack. Loads. I've done a video on it already. Like when I went to Argos and this man brought in a full chip pan thing, you know, the chip cooker, deep fat fryer thing, full of oil to prove that it didn't work because he thought that it wouldn't be believed to get an exchange. When I went to Otto Shoes, this man just walked in and said, I want some replacement shoes for the ones he had on his feet. And he refused to leave, so he had to get security. Iceland, when one of the freezers caught fire. Customers, you see, in fire, I'm going to do a video about this as well. When there's a fire in a shop, you do loads of training and stuff, saying, oh yeah, this is what you do, you evacuate the shop, blah, blah, blah. What you'll actually find is that absolutely nobody will actually evacuate from the shop. They wanted to take pictures of the fire. They're wanting to continue shopping. so the shop can be full of smoke, as it was, flames, actual flames. It was on fire, the freezer. Still wanting to do the shopping. Didn't want to leave. We had to actually rub things out of people's hands and put them down and get them out the shop. To the point where we was almost pushing people out the shop. It was ridiculous. Expert timing. That's someone in an Iceland uniform just walked by. So, JJS Free Time. Yes, a video of smart meters. Am I the only one? Only one without this meter. Maybe there's another one, but one of it. But yes, I have tested this EMF meter and it's well bad. Yeah, because it's something they're going to switch. I don't know the full details yet. I'm still looking into it and stuff like that. But bigclav.com, if you've subscribed to his channel, goes into a better detail because he's more up on this because it's his profession. So the gist of it is, I think that the electricity in this country, what we use now, we only pay for what we actually use. But what these smart meters will do will start charging you for how much you've demanded from the grid in the first place. So even though you'll only use 4 watts for a light bulb, say, they'll actually charge you for 16 watts because the light bulb itself demanded 16 watts for it to be brought down to 6. I don't know if that's what it is, that's what I mean. So if I'm wrong there, I'm still looking into it. I need 100% clarity on it before I make the video of it, because this is something that's important, isn't it? Sorry, Charlie, didn't mean to call you that, said Jay Phantom. There you are, right? James Gooden put, I can't believe that camera's standing like that on the underground train. I wouldn't leave a camera like that on the underground train. Well, I was by myself in that carriage, but for one other person, and it was a Sunday, so it was really quiet. I wanted to move in a minute because someone's telling me to move. JJ's Free Times put, I love AbFab. And I love AbFab as well. So, they've just said thanks now. Apparently I was annoying them. It was on a wall, but hey ho. And then Nicholas has put, have you watched Miranda Sings Oh Miranda Heart? No, I've not seen that. I don't like walking with a camera. I'm going to put it down here for a bit. I'll have to move again because it's on a wall next to someone's house. I don't think I've been that loud. I mean, there's lots of traffic, yet I'm being annoying apparently. But hey, you know, fair dues. Jeff and them's put, wash your bag in the machine. And that is that video from Sunday Outside. This is a terrible angle. This is as quiet as it gets in Hammersmith. So the next video is I hate the end of August. So end of August, I don't like it because it's the end of when everyone's happy. Well, happier really. Everyone starts getting miserable in September because they start moaning about the cold and stuff. And so Kirsty loves, but I love winter too. The dark nights are and cozy nights. And Craig Tiffany agreed. Me too. Dark nights are brilliant. So I love winter, I really do. James Gordon's put, I agree, I go back to school on the 5th of September, the same day as my birthday, so I'm miserable until about October. I hated having to go back to school as well. You know when people say, school's the best days of your life? No, they're not. I would never go back to school. I've never gone back to one of them stupid school reunions either. Why do you want to go back? Unless it's to glow. Oh, you've married some celebrity who was massively famous or something. What's the point of going back? Oh, hiya, Charlie. What are you doing with your life? Oh, work in a shop. Oh, yeah, I've really done something with my life. Stupid. Mary Lee McPherson's put, Charlie, I disagree. I have looked forward to the end of August since June, actually, before weather turned hot. The reason is in Canada, a serene, quiet place at the lake. The weather isn't ghastly hot, dry. For a week, we boat around the bugs. Long walks around the shore and trails through the woods. The weather is still warm, yet comfortable. Doing any activities? All in water and chopping wood done without soaking your clothes with sweat. Also, the weather always gives me more opportunity to cook more meals over the open fires. The warm autumn days riding on a motorcycle beats the heat of wearing leathers. Can't wait for September. You see, yeah, that's I do like winter and I do like autumn, and spring can be all right if it's cold, lovely. Right, no, it's just specifically the end of August, because that is generally when most people start moaning. Charlie Brown's, but I think December is my favourite month. Went through a period as an older teenager of hating the time around Christmas because it was disappointing not being a kid anymore and not having all the excitement, but then I got over it, and nowadays it's my favourite time again. Easy to moan about the seasons, isn't it? But I like how in the UK we have distinctly different spring, summer, autumn and winter. I like that as well. And definitely ready for it getting colder though, and hopefully for some snow this winter.
Me too!
I hope we get some good snow like we did last time, or even better. Samantha Williams has put, I'm a big baby Charlie, I hate the cold, and we'll be the one who hovers over the oven every morning when I go to work. I do own a hot water bottle as well, which I will use every night. I even use the air dryer to blow hot air into my trousers before I put them on. We have a coal fire, which is cosy. Oh, when I grew up in the very first house I was growing up in, when I was up till I was about 5, we had a coal fire. It was great for chestnuts and whatnot. It was so good. And the smell of coal as well. A coal fire is really good. A coal fire which is cosy on a dark night. But I have to say the novelty is worn off since we've moved in a few years ago because of the mess it makes. I know, it does make a mess. It's really dusty, you get a lot of dust. I do love going out for a walk when it's cold and windy though. Love the sound of the leaves and the wind. I just put my big coat on and scarf. Don't like wearing a hat. Don't have the heating on overnight. Just use the winter duvet and a huge fro and I'm sorted. It's fabulous, isn't it? I love the winter. Andrew Ricks has put, I'll at the end of August as the kids are going back to school. But just like it for back memories of it. Yeah, that is the plus. The kids are going back to school, which is great. when you're older, it is. You know, obviously, if you're younger and you're still at school, it's not. City West Island's world-class business campuses, but I totally agree. I am like this as well at the weekends. DJ Three Electricals, but there's a reason Green Day made a song called Wake Me Up When September Ends.
That's true.
S125-ish. Yeah, August is not my favourite month. In Scotland, the schools start back between the 15th to 25th August. No, that's a day after our birthday. I'm glad I'm not Scottish. They have been off since the end of June. Weather not being good August for a long time now. My favourite is spring and early summer, March onwards. S125, I started driving around the bend, going back to school in August. Absolutely not. And then Nicholas has put to a spoof about the scam woman. Scam woman. Oh, don't know what that is. Oh, you have to tell me, Ellie Nichols, I've forgotten who you mean. Doherty, I'm sorry, I don't know how to pronounce your last name. It's different, it changes, doesn't it? January is my birthday month. Oh, that must be bad. Because people have got over the happiness of the holidays and whatnot. And then you're trying to make them happy again and they're forced to be happy for your birthday. Craig Tiffany's put, old brats are back at school. Results. True. It's nice to get on a bus without so many screaming or annoying brats on it. MJ Music's put, I'd like to ask as well, how many flaming products use the smart tagline now? Has it not been copyrighted, or can it not be? It's on everything and every bloody, and it's bloody annoying. How can the same word be used to describe a phone also be used to describe a bottle of water? Yeah, smartphone, smart water, smart meter. It's true. Things go around in circles, though. In the 1980s and the early 90s, it was a lot of... everything was turbo. So everything was turbocharged, and everything was turbo this, turbo that. This is more pointless bibbing in the background. You're not supposed to enter into a yellow box. Yeah, one of these cards in the background. One of them two. Don't know which one it is. Maybe that one there. One of these three. Oh, it's that one there. It's bibbing. Because it's too impatient. Because the red light is on and you see that box junction there, you're not supposed to enter that. I don't drive, but I know this information. But anyway, let's make a lot of noise and keep bibbing the horn and hopefully I'll get what I want, eh? And they're still doing it. They're all trying to drive around him, look. So this yellow van, look, is doing exact, well, he's a bit over the into the crossing, which is bad, but he's doing the right thing. You can't get into there and they're all bibbing him, telling him to drive round.
right.
What a bunch of inconsiderate, impatient, annoying people. I hate Hammersmith's traffic so much. This is just noise. Unnecessary, uneducated noise. It's stupid. So glad I don't live in Hammersmith. Do you just for the time of the winter? See if in Ireland, at least here in Ireland, we have October bank holiday. Yes! We need another the England and Scotland and Wales need a bank holiday in between August and December for Christmas. Look how we're going to put this is gold. It may still be August, but I've actually noticed it's slightly cold now outside, and it's hilarious given the weather we have had a few weeks back. True. Look how we're going to put dark afternoons incoming. Yes, I like it when it's dark. I like it when it starts getting dark at about 4 o'clock. Fabulous. MJ Music's put, I'd scrap the first 5 months of the year and just keep June, July, August, September and October, and probably go November and December can stay. But yeah, my favourite, have you seen, what's his name? And he had that series on Taskmaster. Not Taskmaster, I'm bloody Dave. Dave Gorman! And he said about the months of the year, how they could all have the same amount of days in, but we would have to have a 13th month. Excellent series. I think we should move over to the Gorman calendar. Absolutely. Our birthdays would all change. I'm fine with that because my birthday still falls into the summer holidays. But it's a really good idea. And it really would put September, October, November and December back to where they should be. So obviously October would return to be the 8th month, for instance. So there's that. Next video is rush washing uniform. Just in the other Hammersmith station now. Because, oh no, it's Sunday, innit? Oh, it's obviously Tesco's shut. I'm thirsty. Oh, could have got a Mackie D's. I'm going to go to Mackie D's. Oh, I like this angle. This one's nice, isn't it? It's a bit dark, but I am filming off my phone, by the way, not my normal camera. And that's to speed up editing. So, rush washing uniform. Soprano pictures put. Buy a few more. Said everything to do with that. I really hate buying uniforms. So I need to remember where the camera lens is on this one. Is it there? Where is it? Oh, it's there. I'm up here. I'm looking in the wrong corner still. Hi. I hate buying uniform. If I work somewhere, I want uniform. And so many places now only provide the top half of your body, which is really annoying. But thankfully now, people are a bit more relaxed workplaces now about you wearing jeans, which are a lot more hard wearing. Because before they used to make you buy trousers, and they used to wear in the thigh area, didn't they? Far too fast. But when you wear jeans, at least they last a bit longer. By the way, this is not sponsored by Mackie D's or anything. To the place that's open on a Sunday night. Well, they're in, but you know what I mean. Jay Phantom's put, you should have used the quick wash program. The shirt wash is 20 minutes, quick wash is 30 minutes, and I failed to see the difference between them, to be honest with you. That washing machine is generally a liar, and it just showed me up on that video. I couldn't believe it did it to the minute. I'm really annoyed. Jay Phantom's then put, never rush wash effects wash results. Never rush wash effects wash results. I know, yeah, I don't need to put my shirts into a proper wash on a proper heat, not just 30 degrees. You know, these stupid soap powders saying, ooh, wash at 20 degrees, wash at 10 degrees. No, I like clean clothes. I'm going to wash at 50 degrees if I want to wash at 50. And I'm going to put whites on at 90 degrees because that's as hot as my washing machine goes. And bed clothes as well, you should always make sure you wash on a hot cycle. You shouldn't wash your clothes, your bed clothes in stuff that's too light. I had a feeling then that someone's going to tell me off. You know what I mean? They shouldn't do though. I'm in a bus station, for crying out loud. The lighting would be, there's a light right next to me, which is like right there. And if that light comes on during this video, that would be really, really helpful because it would help my lighting. Samantha Williams has put, I sympathise with your child. There's no worse than getting into bed and realising you forgot to wash your uniform. It's so annoying, isn't it? That realisation that you're going to have to get out of a nice warm bed. Not only that, but you're going to get out of bed to do something for work that you had to go to sleep for to get up to do. Jayfenders, put, you need to boil wash them to get them whiter. Yeah, I'm going to put them in a decent wash. It's just because I wanted them clean rather than white. The other one's more blue than this. Just 3 times, put wash in liar, lol. It is, that washing machine is a liar and the dryer is even worse. Just 3 times, put, my old washer was a big liar. It said 1 hour something, it was more like 2 hours. But I now have a better one and it's well fast. Once long ago though, we all had washing machines that didn't give you any time at all. You just had to guess. They'd be that booklet, wouldn't they? And it'll say how long it is, but it was never right either. Washing machines are just liars. If you ever end up in court and your only witness is a washing machine, best not call it as a witness, because it'll just lie. So, where was you at 5 o'clock? Then you bring in the washing machine.
Oh, I was actually out.
No, I wonder, I was inside, I was waiting for you to finish your cycle. What are you saying? DJ3 Electricals put, when you're about to go to bed and you remember you've got something important to do, you've got to get out of your nice warm bed, turn all the bloody lights on and do your job whilst effing exhausted. You will feel like crap. Even if it's something short like washing a uniform or brushing your teeth, you still feel like crap. It's an awful situation to be in. It is. It's awful. So yeah, this is the bus station behind me, by the way. I think I've already said that to you, haven't I? So as people wait for the bus, there's an ambulance and two police cars over there, so they're probably going to start going ooh, in a minute. Jay Phantom, do you ever use long washes? Yes, I do. I like clean clothes. You should never put everything on a quick wash. Quick washes is only for a half load or for a few items. I know some people use a quick wash for like a full load of washing and it doesn't wash your clothes. And anything to do with bedding, I like to get something that can be put on a very hot wash. There we go with sirens. You'll always get a lot of sirens in Hammersmith because this is the gyratory system. So all you get is a lot of traffic just going round in circles. And say if an ambulance starts here and it needs to get to there, it's got to go all the way around to get to it. It's ridiculous. It was like a 1960s idea that they're trying to get rid of, but it's too late for Hammersmith, so they've had to keep it. Hawaii's put, where do you work, boss? I work in a very well-known theatre and I work in a chocolate shop. I don't say the names, even though probably a lot of people already know where I work by name, because it's just not really for protection from people like you at all. It's absolutely not to do with that. It's more from people who work within those companies who could actually cause more trouble for you, which they have in the past when I worked for Iceland. I used to be quite open that I worked for Iceland, thinking, well, what is there to hard? And it's just like, well, actually, it turns out you'd be surprised. Really effing annoying because I need my jobs. It's 2 0-hour contracts. Well, the chocolate shop's 12-hour now, but it's difficult trying to get the hours. It's already, it's one of them really annoying things about the Conservative government, but you know what? It is actually quite easy to find a job. What is not easy is getting the hours. You need 40 hours, don't you, to get by. And you just can't get it. So that's why I've ended up 2 jobs, and it's a job within itself, making sure that them 2 jobs don't clash. So it's really difficult. It really is. And if anything stuffs either of them jobs up, I'm stuffed, really. Next video, crisp review. Just about to change the background. I love this pipe. I've actually balancing my camera on this. This is why I've moved the camera again. Really good. I keep wanting to talk in this corner because I'm on the phone the other way around. That's how it records. Soprano Pictures, crisp review. Charlie, been watching lots of your old Iceland meal reviews. Why do you never review meals anymore? Seems to be just snacks now. Also, fast food reviews are good. Young Burgers of the Month, etc. Yeah, I used to do a lot more, especially when I worked in Iceland, and particularly when I worked in Uxbridge, because there was loads of opportunity to do that. There's nowhere, this is a good example actually, there is nowhere to relax and sit down in Hammersmith. So if I was to go to McAdee's or Burger King or even KFC, which are incredibly really good, I think I would have been 3 times in my life. I've then got to find somewhere to sit. To put the camera down, if it's this is my proper normal camera that I film off, and then review it in quietness. And it's so difficult in Hammersmith, you can't do it. Shepherd's Bush is quite similar, there's a problem there as well. But that's just London for you. Pardon me, sorry, belching from a Maccadee's Coke Zero. Once again, not sponsored by Coke Zero either. No, it was easier to sit down in Uxbridge outside and stuff for like fast food because you've got to eat it straight away, haven't you? And as for prepared meals, I don't really eat a lot of them anymore. I really don't. I just generally tend to eat on the go, like peanuts or some pepperami or some Babybel cheese. And I'm losing loads of weight at the minute as well from doing that. More protein, less carbs. And ready meals are usually full of carbs. But some random pictures, I probably will do more food reviews. In fact, I've got one coming up. Yes! I'm off work tomorrow and it could be, it won't be tomorrow's video. Because I've just remembered, I've got another dead shopping centre video, you know, dead Mall UK video I'm doing, and it's Croydon. Yeah, so I need to do the voiceover for that. That'll be probably tomorrow's video, probably, not will be. DJ3 Electricals put, I'm personally not a big fan of Doritos, I'm more of a Hula Hoops or Walkers guy. I doubt a lemon flavoured crisp would taste nice, however the honey ribs sound interesting. They seem to be similar to the honey butter crisps from Korea, which are lovely. Oh, they do sound nice. As for the Hula Hoops flavours, they're kind of generic, but they don't look bad. Sometimes simple is better. Yeah, it was like really crispy sort of puffed up things, a bit overpriced for what they are. I've tried the ready salted version of them and they're quite good. I'm tempted to buy the cheese, although I'm not a big fan of those puffy cheese crisps. Then they do taste exactly like that, so if you don't like them, then you won't like them all the Roops cheese flavour. I've tried the ready salted version of puffy cheese. I'd hesitate with the salt and vinegar. I never like salt and vinegar, and I despise vinegar. I'm more of a ready salted or smoky bacon person. Oh, if all the Roops are a smoky bacon flavour of those, they're really nice. Also, I'm requesting a review from the Transformer Snap Crisps of those new and nasty beef-flavoured pepperamis. Beef-flavoured pepperamis are rubbish. I've eaten them before, so I can't really give them a real review because I've already got a preconception of them. Whenever I do a review, it's of something I've not tried before. I think I've only done it once, maybe twice in the past. I've actually done a YouTube video of something I've already eaten before, then reviewed it. It's getting really dark now, isn't it? And now I'm going out of focus. Jordan. Now, is it Gill or Jill? It's G-I-L-L. So, I hope I've got it right. Still waiting on your bachelor's pasta and sauce. Pasta bake recipe. I thought I did that video. Didn't I do it? I will do. I thought I'd done that video. Robert Normandale's put, I can't wait to watch you Sunday outside. There's going to be loads, and as your recent videos are getting quite a lot of comments. It's also my birthday on Sunday, lol. Keep up the good work. Oh, happy birthday, Robert Normandale. If it's your birthday today, as it's Sunday. My shoe, it's Monday outside, isn't it? Happy birthday for yesterday. James Cuddon's put, I haven't seen those other groups before, although I've tried those Doritos and I love the only grazed ribbon lemon flavour. They're gorgeous, aren't they? In my top 10 favourite crisps I've had. Unfortunately, I doubt they'll be out for long. That will be probably the case. Lewis Bassendale, or Basindale. Those Doritos seem like crap. Please try the new Twinings tea water bag things. And I did. So we'll be getting the comments in that video. Government margarines put, Charlie poured all four bags into a bowl and ate it for his tea. Take that, Jamie Oliver. Not quite, I didn't quite do that, but I did eat a lot of them in one go. Big Joe Angels put, my favourite Doritos are the Tangy Cheese. They are good. They go great without salsa, they also do. Usually wait till they're on offer then grab both. Perfect combo of crunch, cheese and super tangy heat. Actually got some in the cupboard fridge right now. Nom nom nom. Delicious. This is all this talk about food's making me hungry now. It's really dark. I've had some of the camera in a minute, so I've actually got some more light. Diad Stevens, but Charlie, you should try the new Walker's Poppables. Oh, I've already tried them already, so what about reviewing them? They're all right. Yeah, I liked the barbecue rib ones. That was good. Ellie Nichols has put, try Walker's Poppables. Just said, yeah, I did. Richard Stevens, but why are you mumbling about the price? You're the one that's eating them. Don't review them if you don't want to pay out. That's the price for fame, honey. Richard Stevens. Well, when I opened the bag, I was just saying, it's just that for what they are, it isn't really worth the money. So if there was an offer, maybe get them on offer, but don't pay a pound for them. If there was like buy two bags for £1.50, that'd be alright. Because it's just cheap crisps, really. Richard Stevens has put, oh no, I just said that. Creative has put, I had the cheese flavourings. They're not that strong a flavour. Doritos Habanero was nice and spicy. The guacamole was strong tasting. Only glazed and lemon were interesting. I tasted more of the lemon. They were really nice. That was really good, them crisps. NTRCZZZ's put, I don't know why, but I didn't like the honey glazed too much. And the habanero and guacamole was nice. Different opinion. And Smack Smashin's put Nuwun. N-U-U-U-U-R-W-N. Maybe I said something that sounds like that. I don't know what that means. Oh no, I'm uncool. I don't know what that means. I'm not a fan of motorbikes. Just unnecessary noise again, like unnecessary bibbing. Next video is offensive urination snack.
I need this light to come on, that's what I need. Come on! I'm shouting at street lights. I'm gonna hold my camera for this bit because I'm waiting for them lights to come on. Mam Stafford's put, what a silly sign. The Tories quite openly shit on people and I don't see a sign on a lamppost for that. I know. Mark put, how is he standing? He ain't got a foot either. And it was just a stupid sign, wasn't it? Did just three times put, well now, I have seen everything. And I replied, no you won't, you've never seen everything. There's always something more ridiculous and annoying to be offended or shocked at. Big Shanks has put, lol, menaced. I know, there should also be a woman squatted down doing the business as well. Chadster123 has put, my friend works for ATV2, would you be interested in some works? I had a presenter for an upcoming show in 2019-2020, thanks. I'm not too sure, Chadster123. I'd rather if your friend got in contact. It depends where it's for. I mean, it could be something really embarrassing. I don't want to do that. I like to embarrass myself on camera as it is, but I'm in full control when I'm making the video as well. Hannah Star once put, a woman squatting, haha, that has made my day. Shepherd's Bush Green, how lovely. I don't understand why it's on Shepherd's Bush Green. It's just a load of trees. There's loads of other places where people might be urinating, like in the fire exit at Marks and Spencer's in Hammersmith, actually. It absolutely stinks. Steph James put, haha, you're as funny as, thank you very much. Wow Pops put, Charlie, I am offended you ass... Ooh, pardon me, I'm still belching. Charlie, I am offended you assumed the gender of that figure on the sign. I know. He stood up and is weeing against something. How dare I assume that he is male? And I still said he. Outrageous, aren't I? Craig Tiffany's put, for taking the piss. Breadcrumbs has put, my recommended videos are in the right state after watching this video. That's so funny. He says, it's currently telling me I should watch All About Boys Puberty and Natural Remedies for Erectile Dysfunction. Mixed messages or what? And James Godden's put, I know people are offended by everything these days. It's ridiculous. Oh, you said this and you can't say that. People like that these days. It's really frustrating, isn't it? People really need to get a life. If you're offended by something, I don't care. And you need to stop this over self value of yourself that you're so important that just because you are offended, you think it means and it's worth something. It really isn't.
I've probably offended lots of people with some of my YouTube videos. And do I care? No! Get a life! In fact, I like to offend people. It's easier, just sorts out the wheat from the chaff, doesn't it? So, that's probably why I've got 3,000 subscribers rather than 3 million, but hey-ho, what can you do? I'd rather have honest subscribers, good subscribers, rather than just faddy ones who hang around for 5 minutes, afraid of being offended. What's the point? What's the point in life if we all thought the same? And if we all ate the same food, because we should all eat the same food or something, you know what I mean? It's ridiculous. Next video is... what is the next video? I've just walked across a bus crossing without looking. That was dangerous, wasn't it? Oyster card fill. Ah, this'll help. It's one of them BT things that no one uses ever. So, let's see if this helps my lighting situation. Ta-da! Oh, my camera's down here now. Hello. Right, so next video is Oyster card fill. You know, Charlie, just saying... yeah, the giant white letters saying co-op should be a giveaway. Yeah, this is because I always get me... oh, I'm looking up there too much now. This is because my Oyster card and the co-op card look really similar when they're in your card wallet. And it's really irritating. The amount of times I've tried topping up my co-op card at the Oyster machine, I tried getting onto the tube with my co-op card, or getting on the bus with my co-op card, or trying to scan my Oyster card when I'm paying for stuff at co-op. It's ridiculous. DJ3 Electricals put, should have gone to Specsavers. AZ has put, I keep my Oyster card in a tiny pocket inside my regular pocket. Don't have to worry about taking out my wallet. And I replied that once that I got it stuck in my top pocket, my Oyster card. So I actually just went, like that, on the Oyster card reader, which was great. Jennifer must have been hilarious. Say it probably looked very, very weird. Very weird. Jim's got his put. I think people are gang disliking your videos again. It's only been on for 5 minutes, and my notification went off, and already it's got a dislike. Said to say, oh yeah, I explained that. Whoever has subscribed to my channel just to dislike every single video that goes up isn't really benefiting themselves and is actually helping me, because first of all, you're a subscriber, thank you very much, and even though you're pressing dislike, that counts as engagement, which is good, which helps my video rise above other people's videos, which means you're helping. So whether it is, well, they're not even watching my videos because they're just instantly disliking them, but that does help, so that's good. I'm not going to say it because it's too flickery, you know, when the advert behind me changes. It changes from this Access the BT phone thing to this Samsung Galaxy thing. No one uses these, and I've never seen anyone use these things. It's for Wi-Fi connection and stuff like that. Oh, I love the orange colour. Oh, look at that. That's a lovely colour. That's for the tablet. Yeah, so that's nice. But then it goes to the blue on a look. Cold. Oh yeah, and that was the end of that comments for that video. So next video is, what is it? The Twanin's cold infuse. Making sure I get on the bus with my Oyster card this time, not my co-op card. But I'm gonna get the bus home for the last video and then just get home and start editing all this together. Every seat above the driver, I get control of the window. This bus sounds a bit broken. Can you hear that rattling? Anyway, so straight into it really quick because I don't want to annoy people on the bus. How expensive, said Jay Phantom. They really was expensive. I definitely won't be buying them again. They should be in Food L, really. But that's a series that's fallen by the side, really, hasn't it? Mum stuff has put, I've seen them, but I thought it looked like crushed pot potpourri. It does, doesn't it? And it's still in the bottom of this bag, actually. It's still in the bottom of this bag. All in there. DJ3 Electricals put, what bother having such expensive food spilt all over your bag of the indignity posh accent jokes aside, this isn't particularly very good. Not only is it unnecessarily expensive, but it's also breakies, and not to mention that it's probably flavourless and watery. Whilst it's sugary, it's filled with brim with flavourings that aren't very healthy. Even if they are natural. Exactly. This posh is completely rattling, isn't it? It's not very good. I put breaks down on the way home, you watch. Oh well, make for a better YouTube video, won't it? Yeah, they weren't very good. Wow, pops pop. I've been teabagged in my mouth, so I can understand. Not a pleasant experience. to just read Sam's copyright trademarks, but I do not mind this in water, but I find them pointless as it's close to pop if it's full of sweeteners. So how is this good for you other than sugar? Exactly, sugar is actually better for you because the body just digests it. And whereas the jury is still out on a lot of sweeteners. Samantha Williams put, looked at these in Sainsbury's and wasn't convinced. I drink a lot of fruity tea, Charlie, and they're lovely flavour once they're cooled down. The Twinings bottles were a tenner as well. Bloody rip-off. I know, they are, aren't they? It's just a plastic bottle. Mam Stafford's put, Charlie, have you been teabagged? And Charlie Brown's put, quite a good posh voice. I'd actually get these. Probably like the mix of the fizzy water. There was better yet better in fizzy water. And trying to cut down on sugary drinks, but the price of these takes the piss a bit. 20 of their tea bags usually cost £1.79, so how can they justify giving you three for £1.30? Exactly. What if this would taste the same with one of their normal tea bags? The whole heat treated thing could be a lot of bollocks, so people pay £5.70. That's a really good point, Charlie Brown. What if the normal tea bags would have just worked the same? Mantra, you won't be able to shake it up because it'll probably split the bag, but then just leave it in, just gently agitate the water. Did just read Tam's put, very posh. Ben Jarvis has put, Calypso cups, that's what I was trying to think of the word, Calypso. Craig Tiffany's put, Charlie's posh twin. Big Joe Angel's put, that is the worst product. Yeah, it's definitely one of the worst things ever. And J Phantom's put lol. So thank you So thanks everyone for subscribing and commenting this week. I've had lots of comments this week, that's really, really good. So I'm just going to enjoy the rest of the bus ride home. It's not really a bus ride home really, I've still got to walk a bit after this bus. I'm going to go home, edit all this together. Thanks for watching. Scrass. Well, probably are scrassed already. So anyway, yeah. I should do more hot food takeaway reviewy stuff. You write soprano pictures. I probably will. So, anyway, see ya. Bye.